Hi, my name is Matthew Shoup. I'm from the Cooperative Institute for Research and Environmental Sciences at the University of Colorado and NOAA in Boulder. And right now I'm on an icebreaker in the Central Arctic Ocean coming back from MOSAIC, the first part of MOSAIC. I'm one of the co-coordinators of MOSAIC and I'm pretty excited to share some information about this project with you. About 125 years ago, Fridtjof Nansen ventured off into the Arctic to go study the Arctic for really the first time in some depth. And that historic journey has really provided the context for kind of future studies into the Arctic. The Arctic system right now is changing very rapidly. It's undergoing this huge reduction in sea ice. The Greenland ice sheet is melting. We're seeing changes to the ecosystem, to circulation patterns, to the land surface. All over the Arctic, there's change happening, and so much change has happened since Nansen's time. That change is really captured and epitomized by what's called Arctic amplification, where we see that the temperatures are increasing in the Arctic much faster than around the rest of the globe. This amplification of change is something that's really compelling to us and motivating us to go look into the Arctic to understand why. We have some potential insight into why because of feedback mechanisms, the ice albedo feedback, where warm temperatures melt the ice, exposing more ocean, which absorbs more sunlight and enhances the temperature even further to melt more ice. This is a positive feedback that might be driving this amplification. But there's so many other processes that we must understand to really understand Arctic change and its role in global change. Why do we all care about Arctic change? Well, we care about ecosystems, of course, fisheries, and the role of the Arctic in the global ecosystem. There's all kinds of new commerce happening in the Arctic with the sea ice melting that opens the door for exploring for resources, for tourism, for transporting of cargo, all kinds of different uses of the Arctic system as it changes. Of course, the Arctic is important for weather, interactions with lower latitudes, and that bringing cold air down to mid-latitudes where a lot of people live. And the Arctic is an essential place to study to understand climate and the climate of our globe. Large-scale circulation, lots of other implications for where our global system is going for the coming 100 years or so. An important tool for us to study the Arctic system and its role in the global overall environmental system is climate models, weather scale models, sea ice forecasting models, models of all kinds of different sizes, scales, and complexities. We need to develop these models to understand where our system is going and how can we project that system, predict that system. Models right now are really lacking in information in the Arctic. We just haven't been to the Arctic enough to understand and observe what's happening there and capture that in our models. That's a big gap in our understanding right now and something we're trying to resolve with some new experiments that we're doing in the Arctic. And so one of the big new experiments is called MOSAIC. It's the Multidisciplinary Drifting Observatory for the Study of Arctic Climate. So what is MOSAIC? We're going into the Arctic with a ship to go study this Arctic system in the Central Arctic sea ice. We're gonna take this ship, we're gonna freeze it in the Arctic sea ice, we're gonna put all kinds of instrumentation on that ship. This is instrumentation to look at the atmosphere, to look at the surrounding ice cover, laboratories to study water samples, to look at the biology happening. This ship is gonna be the central observatory for a very complex interdisciplinary study, cutting across the Arctic system. Around that ship, we're gonna have a lot of other devices installed on the sea ice. Devices that need to be away from the ship and the ship's influences to study, say, air that's not disturbed by the ship or turbulent motions. We need to go out there in the ice around to take ice core samples, to take water samples that we can study to look at the biological activity, to look at the structure and other processes. So all this will happen near the ship that's frozen in the Arctic sea ice and right around that ship. But up to 15 or 20 kilometers away, we're going to install additional instrumentation. These are buoys. These are autonomous systems that are going to look at variability in the system spatially around this drifting ship that's frozen in the ice pack. And the whole constellation of all these different instruments and observations are going to drift across the Central Arctic, kind of like Fridtjof Nansen did 125 years ago. We're going to be doing these observations for a full year. This full year extends from September 2019 all the way to the following year of October 2020. Full year of observations in the Arctic. That's really important for us to understand the key science driver for MOSAIC, and that is understanding
the causes and consequences of a diminished Arctic sea ice pack. Embedded in that question are all kinds of other questions that we're trying to answer that are related to the changing sea ice, related to the atmospheric drivers, the ocean drivers, the implication on biology and biogeochemical processes. We've got this multi-scale design for MOSAIC to look at the very detailed processes at our central observatory at the ship, to look at how that fits within a kind of a regional spatial domain across our distributed network, looking at variability and heterogeneity. And then to place all that in this pan-Arctic perspective of all these other observations from other ships, from aircraft, from other observatories and land-based stations across the Arctic, to understand how the observations we make at MOSAIC in the Central Arctic relate to everything else in the Arctic. MOSAIC's very distinctive. We're gonna be there for a full year. That's really important to understand the seasonal evolution of processes and how they're interacting to ultimately determine how fast the sea ice melts or how fast it freezes. It's filling this huge observational gap that we've really been struggling with over the past years. And it's filling this interdisciplinary approach, this interaction between the atmosphere, the ice, the ocean, looking at chemistry, at physics, at biology. This is really a unique approach. And we're looking at the variability and heterogeneity. This is something that doesn't happen that often in Arctic experiments. So MOSAIC's really unique in that regard. And one last thing is we're bringing together such a huge community of researchers from 19 different nations, more than 60 institutions. We'll have more than 400 different individual scientists out on board the ship in the Central Arctic. The total budget's something on the order of $150 million. Really bringing together the expertise and the investment from many different nations, all under one shared goal of studying and understanding this complex interdisciplinary Arctic climate system for a year out in the Arctic.